Hello friends, I'm going to share some important information about the telephone skills and telephone etiquettes. This telephone skills and telephone etiquettes is very, very important communication for this operation and maintenance team, those who are taking facility management system. You know that the O&M team receives maximum complaints from customers, the clients, the employees through phones only. So that they can solve maximum problems just by receiving and answering over phone. And of course, they can create also. This is entirely depends how do you interact, how do you speak over phone. So to convince the customers and the clients and to create confidence in them. So there is a system, there is a process, and it is a skill. So how to talk, how to speak over phone, and what are the etiquettes to be followed? Then I will try my level best to share some information about this. In that first stage, before understanding this telephonic communication, let us understand what is communication. Communication is a process in which sharing information with others effectively. While sharing information depends on the mode we are going to use to share that information. Based on that, there are four types of communication. The first one, verbal communication, or also it's called face-to-face communication, in which the faces of the communicator and the receiver can be seen each other, and information can be shared with others by using words. And the second one, non-verbal communication. Here also, the faces of the communicator and the receiver can be seen each other. The information can be shared not by using words, without using words, by using body language and signs. Especially the dumb people who cannot speak, they are expert in this communication. They use body languages and the signs. And the third one is written communication. This you can share important information with others without speaking, without using a single word, just by writing mails and writing messages. These are comes under this communication. And the last one, very, very important one, telephonic communication. This is entirely different compared to this first three, because you cannot see the faces of communicator and receiver. But of course, nowadays this new technology, it has been proved that you can see that one also. And of course, by using words, you can express that. You can share information. But you have to be very, very careful while receiving calls from others and even making calls to others also. As you know that there is a saying in a corporate field, you can solve many complicated problems by just speaking over phone, and of course parallelly you can create also. That entirely depends how do you use, how do you interact, and how do you speak over phone with others. So I would like to share some important information about this. First, how to receive call effectively. While receiving call, what are the important things to be followed? Here, the first one, lift the receiver and receive the call within maximum three rings. Most of us, we never do this. When other persons call, when you are four rings, just wait for three rings, maximum three rings. Within next fourth or fifth, you have to receive the call and answer the call. And the second one, once you start answering the call, you communicate with others following the four steps. The first one, greeting. And you have to greet the person who called you. And the second one, self-introduction. Introduce yourself, who are you? And the third one, the topic. Listen to that topic. What is this problem? What is the nature of the problem? Listen to them carefully. That is called as a subject also. And the last one, after hearing this, after listening to that problem, after collecting the information about the problem, we have to conclude it. This is also very, very important conclusion. If you speak, if you speak over phone following these four steps, four important stages, your communication will be very, very effective so that you can create confidence in the person who called, who expect you to solve their problems, and it will be more effective also. And let us see in detail about these four steps. First one, greeting. Greeting in a sense, you have to greet the person like saying good morning, good afternoon, good evening, like this. Whoever may be that, the other end of that, whoever may be the person who is calling you, irrespective of his designation, qualification, his position, whatever it may be, greet them. The moment the receiver left the receiver and started answering the call, say good morning, sir, or good afternoon, sir, or good evening, sir. Then after wishing them, after greeting them, immediately introduce yourself. Introduce yourself. Who are you? In this, you can say your name, your organization representing, and also your department, which department you are in working. In case if they have electrical related problem, if they're trying to contact the supervisor or a technician in the maintenance department, if a housekeeping supervisor, if a plumber or carpenter receive the call, it is a nuisance like. So that if you introduce yourself, who are you, what is your designation, which is the department, so that he will come to know that you ensure that his call is landed at the right place and received by the right person. And after introducing yourself, topic, come to that subject, invite that person to the subject topic, telling that after introducing yourself, you tell that, sir, please tell me what is your problem. How can you help you out? Invite him to the top. Invite him to the subject. This third stage, the third stage, the topic is very, very important. When he started explaining his problem, when he started sharing his problem, listen to him very carefully. Collect as much as maximum information from him about his problem. What is his nature of the problem? What exactly is he facing, that information about that problem he is facing. If we collect maximum information about his problem, so that it will help you to solve that problem, and it will help you what exact tools and what exact space required for solving the problem. And the next, after collecting information, conclusion, you have to disconnect the phone. There is a processor to disconnect. You cannot disconnect your phone abruptly. When you follow this order, definitely the receiver will feel very happy and they say, thank you very much. Then you should reply, you're most welcome, sir. It's my duty, sir. It's my pleasure, sir. Saying this, and ensure that person is disconnecting first. Don't disconnect the call before he is going to disconnect, because if he wants to tell some more information about that, if you disconnect abruptly, he feel bad. Here you can ask this one also, sir, is there any other information? Are there any problems to be shared? Just you ask. If they say nothing, thank you, then you can disconnect the call saying that you're most welcome, sir. It is my pleasure, sir. So these are the four steps you need to follow while receiving call. If you speak to a person who is calling from other side, irrespective of designation and the position, definitely it will be very, very effective. So the caller will feel very happy, confident. He thinks that, okay, someone is there to listen to my problem and someone is there to solve my problem. This is what we have to create. This is what we have to ensure. After disconnecting the phone, immediately you go and meet that person. Go to his place and meet that person and see that if it is possible, if it is possible to attend the problem, if the problem is within your reach, you see that the maximum complaints, it cannot be solved immediately. Most of the complaints, it cannot solve immediately. But most of the problems that the spares are required, time is required, and permission is required from your authorized person and the if the problem is within your limit, there is no space required, no permission is required from your superiors, then it can be solved immediately. Solve it immediately. Or otherwise, tell them, take permission, take time for that. You tell them politely, sir, space is required for this and permission is required for from a superior to do this. It will be solved within few days. So this is how you can able to create confidence. It will be more effective. And this conclusion, I told you, this conclusion is very, very important. It gives a good last impression by saying, thanks for calling. It was a nice speaking to you. And replace the receiver correctly on the phone, whether it's a landline or even mobile phones. After interacting with the person who's calling, is complaining you, following these steps, next you go and meet them. You see that how they respect you. It will be that result immediately. And next, how to make call. You're making call, dialing numbers and making calls also. It is a skill. It is an ethic. You have to follow so many etiquettes here also. In this, again, the first step is dial the correct number, check before pressing call button. Here, most of them, they're making so many mistakes. Check the number you are dialing that. Or otherwise, if you have saved his number and his name, just press it. Or otherwise, if you are feeding the number, so check each and every number before pressing the call button. Or otherwise, so that call will, if there is one number different, that call will be landed some way. Normally, we call this as a wrong number. Like, it is not like that. We are doing it wrong. The number is not wrong. It is our mistake. So after the dialing that, after pressing the call button, speak in the following sequence. Again, the structure, the same structure. Greetings, self-introduction, topic, and conclusion also. And here, greeting, similarly, like good morning, good afternoon, etc. And introduction, of course, you have to tell your name and your organization and your department, from which department you are calling. And before coming to the subject, because you are going to share your problem with here, since you are making calls, before sharing your problem, seek the permission from that person. There are so many ways are there. So is this the right time to call you? Can I have your 5 minutes, please? Can you have your 3 minutes, please? Can I speak to you? There are so many. Like this, please seek his permission. Because you cannot expect that in case that person who receives your call is busy with some other work, he is not in the position to receive the call. It is an embarrassing situation for that. You cannot expect. So that in case if he is driving, he is in another meeting, if he is busy, then he will tell, okay, I will call you later on. Or otherwise, so he will tell, okay, you can go with. So seek the permission. Just ask them, can I speak to you, sir? If you say yes, you go ahead. Or otherwise, you can call after some time. And the next time, if you give permission to go ahead, then come to the topic. If a person is in a hurry, don't prolong speaking. Finish off quickly highlighting the main points. He will come to know that. He will come to know by the way he is speaking to you, the tone, voice, modulation, everything. You can analyze it. If he is hurry, sometimes they tell, okay, you tell me what is the problem. So we have to attend some meeting, urgent meeting, I am driving. Then you can finish it off fast. Highlight your problem immediately without prolonging, without taking much time. Then finish it off fast. While concluding, you must say that, thank you for your valuable time. Thanks for listening. It's very, very, very important for us. These are some important points we need to follow while receiving and also making call. And the next part, telephone etiquettes. We need to follow some etiquettes even while making and while receiving calls also. The first point here, have a pen or pencil or pad, etc. readily available nearby phone. Most of the time we will do that when we don't have something, what is that, to note down something, pen or pad. By holding the receiver, we keep on searching for that. Or otherwise, you have to tell us, sir, wait for a minute, I'm searching for pen, I'm searching for a paper. To avoid all these, better we have always have a pen or pencil or notepad nearby, phone on your birthday. So that you can easily note down something if you want to note some information about that. And better we have frequently called numbers so that you can easily dial, you can easily use the numbers, you can able to make calls. And the second, hold the receiver firmly in your hand. This is also very, very important. And most of the time, we'll hold our receiver phone like this. It should not be, it should not be. Hold your receiver phone firmly in your hand like this. And plan your talk or write down the points in advance if required. This is called as a preparation. Most of the time we'll do that after calling that person or establishing the contact, then we'll start remembering, I wanted to say something, I forgot. So avoid this, all this embarrassment. Better you note down some information on the topic, which topic you are going to speak, what are the important points you want to share with him. It saves his time also and your time also. And speak on general topics like how are you, etc. before speaking on the main topic. This will help to make listener feel comfortably and you can assess the state of his mind. This is also very, very important. Instead of directly coming to the point, if you speak casually so that you can analyze his state of mind, whether he is busy, whether he is in mood or not. So generally you can, sir, how are you, sir? Had coffee, had tea, I had breakfast. Then can I speak to you? This up. So by the way he is answering your this questions, general questions, you will come to know, you can study his state of mind. So then you can continue. In case, if you feel that he is busy, you cut it short. Highlight the important person and stop it. And the next. The fifth one, use a simple language. This is very, very important. Most of the time, many people, they use the complicated words so that the people have to refer a dictionary for finding that meaning of that meaning of that words and all. So there is a saying in the conversation, what is a communication? Use words to express, not to impress. Ultimately, the purpose of communication is the other person should understand what you are saying. Then only the purpose will serve. Otherwise, it is a waste of time and waste of currency and waste of money also. So that use simple one language. First to understand which language is capable to understand. What does it follow? If he speaks in the local language, use it. If he's in English, you can. Otherwise, in Hindi. So before communicating with that, try to find out which language is comfortable and use that language. And use simple language, simple words, simple words. And a smile speaking while speaking, this makes your voice pleasant and courteous. This is also. You see that there is a connection in between our facial expression and also our voice. And facial expression, body language, that our voice syncs each other, it will change when you change your voice and modulation. Expression also will change. So that it is very, very important. Smile and see that your voice and your also your it will courteous and it will be pleasant. And get the person name right, use it often, especially while speaking over phone. Better ask his name and use his name frequently in between that. And speak at optimum speed, approximately 100 words per minute. Of course, there is no particular instrument to measure this. Generally in communication, if you speak too fast, they cannot understand. If it speaks so too slow, they take it casually. Never take it seriously. So that approximately it should be in between 90 to 110 words, 100 plus or minus 10 words per minute. Next, ensure the listener is understanding you by asking some questions and confirm. This is also very, very important while speaking over phone. In case you have called your bosses, or you are called your immediate person whom you are going to report and you keep on telling your problems. If that person receives the call and switch on the speaker and he keeps that phone somewhere and is busy in his regular work, So then it is of you will not come to know about this. You are thinking that he is listening to your problems and he keep on speaking, but he is not listening. So to avoid this communication gap, in between you have to confirm. You ask him, sir, is it okay? Sir, are you listening to me? So is it okay, sir? How do you feel, sir? Can I go ahead, sir? He like, ask frequent questions. If there isn't a response to your frequent questions, then continue. If there is no response, don't waste your time and your currency. Think that that person is not listening to you. And let the speaker know that you are listening to him. This is also, neither way, we have to speak like a person, not like a machine. Speak with feeling and concern. This is also. In most of the agencies, that when you call sometime from a, what is that, receptions and some companies, first you will listen to the recorded message. You see that recorded message, there is no feeling in that. So that while speaking, don't speak like a machine, recorded message. Have feeling in that, where you have to vary that voice and have the feeling in that and respect to it. If speakers give some important information, you say that I will make a notice. Speaker get convinced of your seriousness, especially your bosses. When your boss is giving some important instructions, your superior giving some important instructions, so then you tell them that you are going to note down that information so that he feel that you are giving too much importance to this, and definitely if they think that you are going to solve that problem, this will convince them. And the next, if you tell a person that you will call back, do so definitely, otherwise it loses faith in you. In case, sometimes it so happens that you will be driving, you are busy with some other meetings and all, then you will receive very, very important call from important person. So now you cannot answer also, and you cannot disconnect also, cannot neglect also. By that time, normally we say that I will call you after some time, I will call you after 5 minutes. If you say so, that please do so. You call back after 5 minutes, as you said, or otherwise that person will lose faith in you. Next time, he will not take your call seriously. Then messages, when messages to be conveyed like address, email, and the contact numbers and etc., tell words by words 2-3 times. If you want to give your contact number or some address or some email address, normally we say something, we say once, and we will leave it. Then you have to repeat that contact number or email ID, whatever it may be, repeat 2-3 times and ensure whether he has it noted down properly or not. Again, ask him to repeat that what he has written. If there isn't a problem, if there isn't a mistake, please correct it. Otherwise, the purpose will not serve. Again, do not eat, drink, or smoke while speaking or listening to our phone. This is also, it creates a nuisance. Don't try to speak to others while speaking or drinking while having breakfast or lunch or something, because that sound it is generating, the noise or sound we are generating while eating or drinking, that gets magnified and it creates somewhat embarrassing result. It irritates the listeners. Do not do any other work when you speak and listen. When you receive a call, whether it is important or not important, whether it is a serious call or casual call also, first stop other work what you are doing and concentrate on this. Answer to that call. Listen to that call. Don't disturb the surroundings or people while you are on the phone by raising your voice and making sound. This is also, most of the people we are creating this problem. Especially when you are in a company or in an office or in an organization, you are waiting for someone to meet. You will be sitting at the reception. It is even in public places also, while traveling in buses, railway, trains and all. Speak very carefully. Don't disturb surrounding places and also people. It irritates them. In most of the time, most of the people that do this mistake, they start discussing their family problems and their personal problems in the public places. It is like a free entertainment for others. Unnecessary of stripping yourself in the public. It should not supposed to. And next, if required to pass receiver phone to others while speaking, wipe it neatly. Assume that you are talking to someone. your next supervisor of engineers, he wants to talk to that person. Then while handing over the receiver or phone, just wipe it gently and hand over the receiver or phone to them. Otherwise, it irritates them. And they keep your mobiles in silent mode while attending meetings, training, and important functions. This is very, very important. Normally, we carry our mobiles with us, even while attending training programs, meetings, and conference. And that. While attending these type of programs, ensure that don't forget to keep your mobiles in silent mode. So when you receive a call, you should not disturb others also attending the function or seminar or meeting. In case if you forget to put your mobile in silent mode, in case if you get a call in between the meetings, answer that call by covering your mouth and say you are in meeting, he will call you back after some time. If you disconnect the call abruptly, that person will call you again and he will disturb because he is not aware of that where you are. So tell him that you are busy in meeting and he will call you back. And the next. So these are very, very important telephone etiquettes while making call and receiving the calls. If you follow this each and every step, and if you follow the four steps, that is the greetings, self-introduction, the topics, and also conclusion, and see that effect of this while receiving and making call. So I think once again, I will conclude. Before concluding this, I will repeat this. If you follow these steps and if you talk to them, if you speak to them over phone, definitely you can solve most of the complicated problems before visiting, even without visiting that place, just by speaking over phone. Or otherwise, definitely you will create problem. It entirely depends on how do you interact and how do you speak and how do you follow these steps. Thank you. Have a nice day. Please subscribe to this channel for some more information about the technical as well as even soft skill related information also. Thank you.